Hi, guys. Welcome back to Steps to Sobriety. Today, we have got 10 points in 10 minutes with Dylan Lundgren.
Thank you, Stefan, and really good to be here with all of you. And today, we're going to go into the light, as Stefan so profoundly says. And we've got 10 points to discuss with you to help with sobriety or even to help with overcoming mental health challenges. So the first point here, the first tip is have a way to get in touch with your body. Addiction and mental health challenges tend to reside oftentimes starting here in our head. And the beauty of getting in touch with the body is having a way to get in touch with what's happening in our direct experience in the moment. Because when we come into our body, we're coming into the moment. And when we come into the moment, we're disconnecting from the stories that so often can keep addiction going and keep the severity of mental health challenges going. So have a way to get in touch with the body. Along with that, step number two is have a way to get in touch with emotions. So a lot of us that struggle with mental health or substance use challenges have a history of trauma. This trauma may be prior to using substances. It could also be a result of experiences we've had while using substances. So getting in touch with our emotions is learning and accessing some of these perhaps painful or unpleasant experiences that we've had that we maybe have suppressed, and having a way to begin to feel some of that in a safe, appropriate way, not necessarily all at once or all in one day, but being able to start to experience and express some of our emotions. So that's step number two. Step number three here is find your tribe. Find your tribe. When we're using substances, oftentimes our tribe is people who use substances, right? So we connect with people who maybe drink like us or use drugs like us or something like that. But when we come into recovery, what we're coming into is a more purpose-driven life. And we want to find a tribe of people who share values or share experiences that we'd like to have or that we are currently having in a more productive way. And finding those people could look like finding people that we want to aspire to become like, or it could be finding people who have a more similar orientation. That may start off with finding people who are walking a path of recovery to start with in just a more general way. You know, anyone that's walking a path of recovery is a good place to start if we're caught in addiction. And it can become more specific over time. So maybe we find people in recovery who like to run, for example, and we participate in road races together, even run a marathon together. So step number three, find your tribe. Step number four is a little more specific and along the same line. So find a mentor. You know, it's often said that we can't go it alone. And the map is not the terrain. So we might read a book on how to change a habit. We might read a book on how to, for example, get sober, and that can be really useful. And at the same time, we want to have a mentor, somebody who's walked the terrain, who knows the ins and outs of the terrain. And having someone to guide us through that process is really, really important. So have a mentor. Have a source of accountability would be the next tip here. So tip number five, have a source of accountability, which can be an individual. That could also be the mentor. It can be a support group as well. So we want to have a source or sources of accountability that can keep us on the right track. I might say that I'm going to stop drinking, but if I'm holding myself, only myself accountable to that, it's really easy for me to step out or to rationalize, maybe not staying committed to that today. And, you know, we want to have a source or sources of accountability to keep us on track over time. So, for example, this week I'm going to not drink. I'm going to accomplish that by maybe I go to 12-step meetings. I'm going to go to 3 meetings this week, or maybe I go to smart recovery, or maybe I go to therapy, or maybe I exercise, whatever the things are that are keeping me on the path of recovery. I'm accountable to somebody else or a group for those actions. And the next tip here, step number six, is find something that lights you up. That could be, for me, it was spoken word poetry, slam poetry. When I first got sober, I saw this young gentleman in a men's group get up and do what I thought was rap. It actually was spoken word poetry. I thought it was rap because the way he was rhyming and the flow to it, it reminded me of rap or hip hop, except there was more of a, you could say, a sacred element to the way he was sharing it, what he was sharing about. And so I learned how to do spoken word poetry, and it's something I'm really passionate about, and it lit me up. Got me excited. It allowed me to be more authentic. And finding something like that can be really important. It gives some juice, some fuel to the gas tank of our recovery. So find something that lights you up. Having a step number seven, having a safe and supportive space for self-expression. So we're talking about a little at the beginning here, having a way or getting in touch with our emotions, having a space to safely and express ourselves, especially this deeper, darker stuff, can be really important too. So having a space to fully and freely express ourselves, whether that's spoken word poetry or trauma, you know, that having a space for that full spectrum of human emotion and experience, a space where we feel supported and where it's safe to fully express, can be really, really important. Step number seven here, be open to new experiences. So when we're caught in addiction or even a mental health challenge, we can be really disconnected from the spectrum of life, from the potential of our own life and life in general. You know, my father once pointed out that if we look at a painting, you know, one drop of paint is what alcohol and drugs have to offer, right? That's like one drop of paint. And yet we can be so focused on that one drop of paint that we lose sight of the whole painting. And being open to new experiences can be a really powerful, powerful part of this process of recovery, because recovery is not just about putting down the substance. It's really about having a bridge, a way back to life, a way to re-engage with life, and oftentimes in a new way. In other words, experiencing things we've never experienced before. And if we don't know, if we don't try, you know, we may never know, right? We may never know what we like. We may never know who we could be if we don't give it a shot. Step number eight here, step number eight, tapping into the power of self-care. So how often are we running around all day, every day, hustling, which can have its place? At the same time, if we don't give ourselves opportunities to relax, to kind of reset our nervous system, we can get caught in this fight or flight response. We can get caught in chronic stress, which is a precursor to relapse oftentimes. So tapping into this power of self-care, very important. That could be something as simple as taking a nice bath. If you're a fan of Epsom salt can be really good to throw in there and relax the body and muscles and nerves. It could be as simple as getting to bed early, you know, getting that 8 hours of sleep, maybe taking a break and reading a little bit, or, you know, even as long as we're not doing it all the time, maybe watching, you know, binging on Netflix for an hour or two, or, you know, whatever can recharge our nervous system and reset our mind from this hyper-focused or, you know, hyper-aware state. Just giving ourselves time to chill. You know, self-care has a lot of different manifestations. The next one is getting outside. Away from the electronics, away from external influences, just, you know, in terms of daily responsibilities or, you know, things like this, getting outside and connecting with nature, getting some fresh air, you know, getting into a place of peace and quiet can be really, really useful in recharging our nervous system as well. Let's see if I missed any here. So I think that's, I might have missed one there. I feel like I listed off off 10, but maybe I doubled up on one of them there. So to recap, get in touch with your body, get in touch with your emotions, find your tribe, get a mentor, be accountable, find something that lights you up, be open to new experiences, have a safe and supportive outlet for self-expression, tap into the power of self-care, and get outside. So those are the 10 tips for recovery, the 10 tips for recovering from addiction or even a mental health challenge. And I hope you start to integrate even just one or two of those. It doesn't have to be all in one day, even if you just do something today. So I hope you take advantage of it, and I appreciate you having me on here. And Stefan, I'll pass it back to you.
Dylan Lundgren, what can I say? An absolute perfect summary of you know, how to live a life that is so full of joy and serenity, ultimately, what we are striving for. You have given us the roadmap for that. So thank you so much for those beautiful summarized 10 minutes in. It is just perfect, absolute perfect. You just describe what I try to do every single day and what everyone in successful recovery is doing. So thank you so much for putting it in such wonderful words. Dylan Lundgren, 10 points in 10 minutes. Look after yourself.